Hey guys, it's Will with another solo episode of First Watch, my series within a series that I'm doing on the Cold War Spy Thrillers box, which I have right here. It's not really a box, I guess it's just two discs, but there's six movies in here, and these are all Columbia Pictures films. And the one I'm going to be talking about today is called The Deadly Affair. This is like very much a prestige picture, and I was really surprised that I had never heard about this before, because as I said in my review of the first film in this series, I really like espionage stuff from this period and spy stuff and, you know, like TV shows like The Avengers and the James Bond movies and stuff like that. So The Deadly Affair was directed by Sidney Lumet, scored by Quincy Jones. It's adapted from a John le Carré novel, and it stars James Mason, who's a big star from England, and a bunch of other actors of that nature. So it's like a pretty big like prestige type project for that time. And I think one of the reasons that it is maybe, and this is just me kind of making stuff up off the top of my head, but my guess would be one of the reasons this movie does not have like a big historical reputation, or maybe wasn't a huge hit, or isn't as well remembered as a lot of other spy movies from that period, is it's very, very, very English. All these people have very thick accents. They talk quickly. They mumble. There's no attempt made to give any concessions to like an international or to an American audience. It takes place in London. You have Cockney characters. You have kind of like historical and social context that I think a lot of Americans would probably miss. My mom is from London, and she grew up in this time period. This movie came out in 1966, if I didn't say so. She would have been like a teenager at that time. So this is like a social and historical context that I know really well, and I don't really have a problem with English accents because I have a ton of English relatives. I spent a lot of time there as a kid. And so, like, this is a movie that I really, really loved, in part because of the social and cultural context of it. And, like, the location, it's all location photography in London, which is really, really cool. And you have characters who are, like, these upper-crust government people, and then you have these, like, cockney, like, street cop type guys, and kind of, like, everyone in between. It's a really cool, like, cross-section of society in London at that time. So the movie is about a British government official who is asked to go and talk to another British government official who used to belong to the Communist Party, because his name has come up for a promotion, and they just have to make sure that he's not involved in anything like related to international espionage, basically. It's kind of like a formality, right? So he goes and talks to this guy, and then the guy kills himself. And in his suicide note, he blames this government official for his suicide. And so the guy then has to investigate basically what's going on. And he gets paired up with this retired agent who's like this Cockney guy who's more like rough and will like go and beat people for information, that type of thing. The two of them go and they talk to this guy's widow, and they talk to his coworkers, and they get involved in this mystery that all takes place in London. So it's not an international spy movie. And it ends up tying into the Cold War and international espionage and all this stuff like this. But it's a really well, I mean, obviously, if you have ever seen any John le Carré movie, or if you've ever read any of his books, he's an excellent storyteller. He writes excellent thrillers. Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy is probably the most famous, I think, thing based on his books. Also, there's, what's that other really famous one that's escaping my mind right now? The Constant Gardener is one of his, and I think maybe, Taylor Panama, like that type of stuff. So they're really great stories. So unless you really screw up the adaptation, you're going to end up with a really good spy movie. So, I mean, that, there's not too much to say about this. Like, this is a really well done movie. Like, it, you see Sidney Lumet's name on it, and you're like, oh, is this maybe one of his like misfires because no one really knows that much about this movie? No, this is a very well done movie, and it involves a lot of really interesting subplots that end up connecting. The lead characters, played by James Mason, was in, I think, stationed in Austria as an intelligence agent during World War II, and an Austrian guy that he used to work with comes to London, and there's a whole subplot with that that's really interesting. And then something else that's really, really interesting is his wife is like a much younger woman who I think is Polish, and she has this like insane libido, and so she goes off and sleeps with all these other people, and he doesn't care as long as he's the one that she loves and like comes home to at night. And that's really, especially for like a movie of that time, to explore that kind of like sexuality, and also how that ties into the lives of these characters and the kind of the criminal underworld that's happening at that same time with this plot is really interesting. So I highly recommend this movie. I really liked it. It's called The Deadly Affair. It's directed by Sidney Lumet. Really cool music. Like I said, Quincy Jones did the music, so it's super cool music. Adapted from a novel by John le Carré. And it is in this spy, Cold War spy thriller box set, which you can get, and I will include links in the description of this video, for like, I think it's like $6 or $7 if you do like Best Buy, whatever, eBay, Amazon, wherever you buy DVDs. Definitely check it out.